it's a great show. I haven't made the investment to get into it yet, but yes, people love it. Indeed.
People do love it, so one more on that coming
up. Have a great explosion to look yes. forward to, too, so you got to love that.
Yeah.
Good morning. Thanks for being with us. I'm Steve Lacy.
And I'm Carrie Drew in for Heather Nauer this morning. It is 5:30 on this Friday, August 17th. Thanks for joining us.
Audrey and Inez are here. They're checking on the weather and the traffic. Let's begin with Audrey, though, who's working on a couple hours sleep, but she is still selling the forecast.
She is.
And you know what? Things are going to be changing in our forecast today, folks. We are starting out in the 50s through the low 70s across the tri-state area. Nice big range here. Nice and comfortably cool in Monticello at 55 degrees. We're at 59 in Sussex, 68 at Newark Liberty Airport. But check out Central Park. Nice and mild this morning at 72 degrees. A look at our Sky Guardian radar shows things are nice and dry, but that's going to change as we go into the afternoon. We have a cold front that's headed in our direction, and that's going to help spark off some showers and possibly some thunderstorms later on today. So have that umbrella as you head out the door this morning. We'll have a mix of sun and clouds for the morning drive. Lunchtime looks pretty good. Actually, you know what, this has not been updated, so let me go like this and tell you that later this afternoon, you want to have the umbrella handy because we are going to expect scattered showers, and I'll let you know more about that and have this updated for you coming up in a few minutes. But for now, let's check out on your commute update with Inez Rosales.
Hey there, Audrey. Well, the commute right now, we do have some problems out there. Let's start off first with the George Washington Bridge. No problems there if you're taking that this morning. Everything looking good. You can see traffic slows down a little bit here at the cash toll lanes. But
that's great.
And thunderstorms, they will die down, though, after sunset, and then temperatures will drop into the 70s. We'll clear it out by tomorrow afternoon. Check out the numbers, though. Behind the front, we're going to have our highs drop into the low 80s, and that'll linger right into the beginning part of next week. Let's look at your weather. Now let's check in with Inez and see how the commute is going.
Hey there, Audrey. You know, not bad, actually. We do have a few things here and there you want to watch and keep an
eye around.
Yeah, which is the movie night of the two, tonight or tomorrow night?
I would say tonight, not tomorrow night. Tomorrow night you should be in the clear, and I think tonight we're just going to get some scattered showers. Some spots, though, could get some isolated thunderstorms, which will provide for some heavy downpours. Right now we're starting off dry, though. Temperatures in the 60s across much of the area. Central Park, though, checking in at 72 degrees, and we're a little cooler to the northwest here. Sussex is coming in at 59 degrees. Monticello is at 55. A look at our Sky Guardian radar shows things are nice and dry right now, but that will change as we go later on into the afternoon hours. A couple of high clouds are in place this morning. The sun will be setting shortly after after 6 o'clock this morning. And as it does so, we'll see plenty of sunshine this morning. Then a cold front will be coming in from the west here. That's the one that's going to ignite some showers and thunderstorms. Right now, it's providing a couple of hours. As it approaches our region, we'll start to see them become more numerous throughout the region. It could be an isolated thunderstorm, too, especially north of I-80, and that's where we could get some heavy downpours later on tonight into tomorrow morning. So here's the front as it approaches on our future cast here. It's going to kind of hover in the morning hours tomorrow, so I think on Saturday morning we'll start out with a couple of showers. In the afternoon, though, we should see the sun breaking through. High pressure will come in from the west, and that will give us a really nice Sunday to close out our weekend. So today we'll have a mix of sun and clouds. It's going to be very warm, too. High temperatures near 90 degrees in a lot of spots. Will actually be above 90, like in interior New Jersey later this afternoon. Watch out for those showers later today. They'll probably come in after about 2 or 3 o'clock, and they'll linger into tonight. Tonight we'll have some scattered showers and isolated thunderstorm. Temperatures dropping back into the 60s and 70s. Looking ahead at the next several days, the front will clear everything out by Saturday afternoon, and then look behind it. We're going to have high temperatures in the low 80s by then, and overnight lows will be in the 50s and 60s. So after tonight's rain, we have a really nice stretch of weather as we go into next week. Carrie, we're going to go to Inez with a check of our traffic. That's it. Traffic, Inez, right? You're doing traffic this morning.
Yes, I am. Audrey, listen, you only got 2 hours of sleep. I forgive you. Right now, here's a look.
We have a little cut and stuff. But he wears the helmet, but no mouth guard, right? In baseball,
yeah.
You wear a mouth guard. So,
no matter how much you protect it, something could always go wrong.
It was
like
a ricochet off the bat to the face. Yeah. All right, so let's switch gears and talk weather now. It is 6:10 right now, Friday. We have a summer weekend ahead of us.
We're just going to get through a little rain earlier in the weekend, but then it looks fine, right, Audrey?
For most of us. You know, I've been looking at some of the weather data, and it looks like parts of New Jersey could get a little bit of a soaking as we get into Saturday. We'll talk about that in just a minute. Here's a look at our temperatures right now. No rain right now across the region. We have temperature readings mainly in the 60s. We're at 72 in Central Park. It's in the 50s across northwest New Jersey and also up towards Monticello. Look at our Sky Guardian radar shows we're nice and dry right now. We'll stay that way at least for the first half of your Friday. We do have some clouds that'll be rolling in towards the afternoon, and we're keeping an eye on a cold front that's approaching us from the west here. That's igniting a couple of showers across the Great Lakes, and as it approaches our region, we'll see an increase in shower activity as we go through the afternoon and especially into tonight. I think that's when we're going to get the heaviest rainfalls, overnight tonight into the first part of tomorrow. So the clouds will gradually thicken up from west to east as the front approaches, but the rain should hold off until about 3 or 4 o'clock this afternoon, and that's when we'll start to see rain edging its way into western New Jersey and parts of the Hudson Valley. Some of that rain could come down pretty hard in some of the embedded thunderstorms, and it looks like tomorrow we could see shower activity continuing across southern parts of New Jersey. So if you are heading down to the shore, anywhere from Belmar on southward, plan ahead for maybe some rainfall as we go through the day on Saturday. East end of Long Island also could be lingering in with the cloud cover and some light rain as well. Everyone else should be clearing out from west to east. Now on Sunday, high pressure noses its way in from the west. That should bring a much better half to the weekend. Sun and clouds today, very warm with high numbers near 90 degrees in some spots. Watch out for showers developing later this afternoon. And tonight, we'll have scattered showers and the possibility of some thunderstorms. Those should clear out for most of us, at least tomorrow afternoon. Sunday, mix of sun and clouds. Temperatures drop into the low 80s for highs right into next week. Stephen Carey?
All right, overall, looks pretty good, though. Thanks, Audrey. A decent week on the way. We've got a lot more coming up this Friday morning.
It is 6:12 right now. Let's take a live look.
Along a busy highway in Calgary Tuesday, caught a road sign bobbing up and down. Winds were gusting at more than 60 miles per hour at the time. After the video was taken, the sign did collapse, but luckily no cars were hit. Now inspectors are checking on several signs to make sure they're structurally sound.